What is the first thing you think of when you hear Irish step dancing?
Clover.
River dancing.
Culture.
A river dance.
Thing.
Ireland.
Hi, I'm Shannon Fallon.
Okay, when did you start Irish dancing?
I started Irish dancing when I was in first grade, so I was probably about six. One of my friends that I had when I was little, she was a bit older than me, and she was doing it, and our moms took us to see Lord of the Dance, and I just fell in love with it. I was obsessed with it, and that's all that I like wanted to do after I saw it. Open championship, which is the highest level that you can get into. I danced until my senior year of high school, so it was probably about 14 years. I like to think that I'm still dancing, but not on a regular basis.
See,
and when did you start Irish dancing?
When I was four.
And why did you start?
My cousin had found a dance class, and we just decided to go together, and I stuck with it for 15 years. My family is a huge Irish family, and so that's, I guess, where it rooted from. Well, you prepare two dances for a fesh, and you do each of those dances for the judges, and they take, they mark you for each of those, and they add up the points at the end, and whoever has the highest points for each dance would be the winner. I've competed at the All Scotland Championships, the All Ireland Championships, the Great Britain Championships, and the Nationals.
A fesh is, it's a smaller, it's not like a huge competition, but they're, it's like where you go to compete, and, there's tons and tons of people, and it's crazy madness, and there's dance moms running around, and there's just, it's where you go to compete, and you wear a dress, and I don't know, competition. I competed every year from the time I was in fifth grade at the Oireachtas, which is the regional level competition. I competed at the Nationals, I think about five times, and I competed at the World Championships twice, which were in Ireland and Scotland.
And what are classes like? Are they tough, hard?
Depending on the level you're in, they get harder and harder and longer as you improve and get better and get older. When I was taking lessons on a regular basis, I was dancing about four times a week. I would go to a team practice on Sundays, which was like team dances, Kaylee's, stuff like that. Tuesdays and Wednesdays I would have class with my level, and I would do like stops and run through things like that. And then on Fridays I had a drill class, which was like just like cleaning up stuff and little stuff like that. A regular practice would probably have been an hour and a half to 2 hours. We would go in, stretch for probably about half an hour. My teacher was really into like Pilates and yoga at one point, so we would do ab stuff and exercises, because people don't realize that by Irish dance, you are an athlete. It's athleticism, and so we would work on our core and stuff, and then we would break into like our real groups, who let in slip jigs and your different kind of dances, and then go from there.
We try and dance at least five times a week. Our practice usually run from like an hour and a half to 3 hours, like on a regular basis. We do a lot of strengthening, like core strengthening as well, and stamina work and technique work and conditioning and clutch. The loving school sometimes. Yeah, we're all really close and I'm friends with everybody and we grew up together. So. They're not cheap, and each costume is designed specifically for each dancer. There's no costume that's alike in the solo competition. A lot of people don't understand the wigs and the dresses and, you know, how it works in general. A lot of people think, if you come on stage and you have, you know, a ton of makeup on and you look like a star, it kind of attracts the judge's attention more if you were to not wear something as extravagant.
Kind of the Toddlers and Tiaras effect that's going on right now that it's being compared to. Like, we do wear funny wigs, we do wear funny dresses that we all think are really cool and awesome, but the outside world thinks are completely weird. And the tanning of the legs, I'll never understand that. We're all pale and white, but we have these obnoxiously orange legs, and I'll never understand it. The smell of tanner brings back memories for years for me.
Itself, it's pretty big, but not a lot of people know about it, I guess. I'd say the wigs again. People don't understand why we wear the wigs or why we dance with our arms down or the dresses. They think of like all the traditional things.
Probably how difficult it is. People, I think they judge it and they see people flailing their legs around and they don't think it's as difficult as it really is and how competitive as it is.
They were the ones that always had to drive me everywhere, and they paid for all my costumes and my shoes and everything, and they support me all the time. And everything.
Two times that I got to go, well, the one time I went to Ireland, the second time to Scotland, but it makes you feel more connected to, like, your ancestors, and I don't know, just more connected to your roots.
Yeah, we're we're very disciplined, and we spend a lot of time working for something that we love. And I don't understand why we tan, because Irish are fairly white. I don't understand the wigs, I don't understand the dresses, I don't really understand a lot of it, but I love it, so. It's kind of my life. I don't know really where I'd be without it. It has taught me a lot, it's brought me to a lot of places that I'm very thankful for.
It means to me, it's so dear and near to my heart. It's one of my favorite things, and it is me. I've been in love with the sport and the art form of it since I was a little girl, and it means a lot to me.